walk me through the concept of deciding, you know what, we need to sit down a bunch of celebrities and ask them about pooping.
Well, I don't know if I'd say celebrity.
Comedians, I mean, you know this because you did comedy, Rich, that yes. comedians are amateur anthropologists. We study human behavior.
That's
we say
true.
This is what's funny about it.
And then we reflect it back to the audience with a take and with some comedy mixed in. So we had Pete Holmes, who's a comedian who's fantastic, star of Crashing, yes. Kumail Nanjiani, Eric Stone Street, all these people, different attitudes towards pooping represented. And our friend came to us originally. We didn't have this idea. This wasn't the movie we set out to make no, when we started
we did not
in
set out to.
So it morphed.
It yes. became. Yes. It
gestated inside
it
of us, brewed, and then it became something.
And then it finally came what it was.
Yes. No, but our buddy Aaron Feldman, who directed the film, said, he came to us and said, I want to make a movie about the history of poop. Will you guys help me make it? And we said, no.
Absolutely not. Why would we do that? That's the most ridiculous.
But then we said, well, what if we could make a movie with our funny friends?
Yes.
Make an honest, open discussion about poop, which really becomes a story about a taboo subject that something we all do, but we don't talk about. We pretend we don't do it.
Yes.
And this Tinder, Facebook profile picture where we are all sort of becoming our avatar, which is a high angle selfie
yes.
with like an amazing filter put on it. We don't want to let the world know that we sit down and squat it out, mm-hmm. but everybody does. And to me, that is the moment when we're
the most human that we are.
And Buckeyes fans, Wolverines fans,
everybody
all do
does
it the
it.
Same way.
We can all come,
we can come together on this issue.
Yes, but Buckeyes fans call it the pooping.
They call it the pooping. And when they poop, it's in the shape of a horseshoe. Yes. All right, so. That's actually healthy. That's very healthy.
We all do poop on
a
horseshoe.
That's it. But it was fascinating to do, really fun to do. We kind of learned so much about our friends that we've known for 20 years, 10 years. You're talking about this stuff with them that you would never normally talk about, and suddenly you're learning stuff about them that we would never know. And so it was very revealing and just a lot of fun to do. We made it on a shoestring budget, released in theaters. We went to the theater in Santa Monica and watched it. For opening night, the opening thing, we did a Q&A afterwards.
No,
and
we don't.
Yes. Oh, yeah. It was, you know, sitting with the auteurs.
A Q&A.
Yes.
Q&A.
Both of us were sitting on toilets as we answered questions.
What's to be asked and answered here?
I mean, people asked us,
don't we all just stipulate about
poop? I mean, listen, it was actually really cool that no one in all the people in the theater were strangers.
Okay.
So people came to this movie and it wasn't friends and family. It was kind of cool.
I mean,
I know you have stories.
We all do. I mean, we just showed a clip to our television audience, Randy and Jason Sklar here, the auteurs, if you will. Is that the proper way?
Executive producers.
Hold on a minute. The driving force.
Thank you. Thank you.
Poop talk.
See, he's with it.
You're on it.
Yes.
We just showed a clip of Eric Stone Street basically saying, because he's a public figure.
Totally.
He will not public poop.
It is so embarrassing.
Because people will be able to know.
There's the guy from Modern Family.
That he's been, if he goes to the men's room and he's back in 60 seconds, we all know what he just did.
That's right.
10 minutes. We
did a great run with him in the movie where we made him list all the stadiums he hasn't pooped at.
So
he keeps coming back. He's like, I've never pooped at Qualcomm, never pooped at Levi's Field.
I know I've never pooped in Staples Center.
He's like, I worked in college at Bramlage at Kansas State. I never pooped at Bramlage. It was just great.
And he won't do it. I wouldn't do it either.
Why not?
What do you mean, why not?
I will go anywhere.
I'm with him.
When you have to go, go.
Who has that sort of control is what you're saying.
Yeah, right. Wow.
If you had to go, you would go.
Here's the thing, okay? And I think everybody who's listening to this show and watching it will understand. A men's room is so much more different than a woman's room.
Oh, yeah.
Okay?
Oh,
yes. I mean, it's not like I've been to, you know, hold on. There are times when my 4-year-old daughter's got to go.
Yeah,
and I knock the door out and I'm like, is anybody in here? And I take her in there and I walk in. And
it's gorgeous.
There's
artwork.
Steam. Oh my God.
There's artwork.
It smells good. There's artwork.
Like there are actual towels.
I mean, it's just like, it is like that Seinfeld episode where
Costanza
walks
bathroom.
In. No, where Costanza walks in the models are all over the place.
Yeah, right? It opens up.
It's incredible.
Yeah.
We men are just, we're animals. We're monkeys. It's just
animals.
And so I will not, guys will not lift a seat when they've got to go one. It's terrible. It's awful. So when you've got to go two.
But what if you have
in the hell are you?
What if you
clean it?
Mexican and you got to, and it goes right through you. What do you do?
You just eat Mexican close to home. Yeah, I guess right. Rich just plans out where it's going to be.
All I know is that should I share it completely?
Share, yes, please. That's what this movie's about, being open and honest.
Should I share completely?
Yes. Please. This is what's all about.
Share. One time at a sporting event in my life.
The Super Bowl.
One time.
The Pooper Bowl.
The 1999 All-Star Game in Fenway Park.
And those bathrooms are like haunted by the ghosts of old.
Carl Yastrzemski took some monster dumps there.
The worst. I mean, I still smell Johnny Pesky's big, big
they
moment.
They called it the Pesky Pole for a reason.
Mo-Vaughn. That was the Mo-Vaughn.
Mo-Vaughn has wrecked many a toilet.
Big Poppy. He just destroyed.
I mean, come on.
The Rich Eisen Show. Weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.